Direct.
Do you like Sonic Youth?
Yes, yes.
Do you like Sonic Youth?
Yeah!
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 Yeah! Sonic Youth!
You like Sonic Youth?
Yeah.
No! You like Sonic Youth?
Yeah? Ah! Daisuke, Daisuke, Daisuke.
Do you like Sonic Youth?
Yeah, sure! I like it, I love it!
Very much!
Sony Music TV.
Sonic
Youth. Sonic
Youth.
もちろん。
Like
this. 大好き大好き。
はいはいはい。
Thank you. Thank you.
My brother came over to my house and tuned my acoustic guitar into some weird tuning and started playing, and he left it tuned, and it wasn't a weird tuning. It was kind of an open tuning of some sort, not too far away from some of our tunings. So.I immediately wrote maybe 4 or 5 songs on this guitar and this tuning. I felt like really inspired by it. And I was planning on doing a solo record of this music. I felt they were somewhat unfinished somehow. And I knew for a fact that if I had given them to the band would take them and transform them into like a unified band composition.
It's all sort of worked out over time in here, and it's sort of like sculpture in a way. We build the things up, we play with the structures, we change things around. People keep notes in different ways. Here's some pages in my notebook for some of the stuff from Murray Street. I've got a little stamp that makes the guitar neck so I can put finger position, since when we play with all these different tunings, these aren't very interesting pages, when we play with all these different tunings,There's, you know, you got to make up the chords as you go along. So you work on the structure over time, and everybody kind of has their own way of notating stuff. And we just kind of work it out.
Pedals that come with some other pedals, they also use 3-pole, and if I connect, then I can wire a whole bunch of pedals that usually you can't control with anything but the knob, and then I can have them all be controlled by one pedal. All I have to do is make one master. If you kind of just go through them, you usually find that. Know why it does that, but immediately, you know, you can get these sounds it's not supposed to make.
I know that when I saw Almost Famous with Thurston, there were parts where he was, you know, nearly in tears when he was thinking about, you know, could have beens, you know, could have been there for Zap, could have been there for, you know, this scene, that scene. You know, he's a little bit behind the eight ball on that, and it's never really gotten past him. I know that when Albini was recording the Page and Plant thing, you know, Thurston was always offering to come out. He's like, oh, Steve, I haven't seen you for a long time. You know, maybe we could get together. You know, I'd like to come out, maybe do some work. You could show me around your studio. And, you know, it's tough for Steve to keep him out of there, really. And so the empty page, I think, has a lot to do with that.
All right, on an empty stage.
they could be voodoo dolls. We don't have any pins, but some fan made a set of dolls of the four of us. This is Steve. This is Thurston. This is Kim. Mine got lost before we left the gig that night, so we don't have the Lee doll anymore. And of course, there wasn't a Jim one back then.
I mean, this is like Jim's solo stuff stands alone. His interpretation of what Sonic Youth are doing added a new dimension to it. I mean, it's so obvious on the new record, but I think now they've got to the sound that I've been sort of wanting them to get to. It's just, it's going to give a lot of bands a run for their money.
I'm going to go upstairs and fix my package.
There was a disc in your drive, Jim.
Really?